Welcome to the Society of Communities Paradigm on March 24th. I think people are hoping that summer is almost here or something. But summer hours or summer reminder in summer, I know mine is, but. So we're also, I'm hoping that you're all in a very new paradigm-y kind of mood. To learn about the new paradigm. What happens in between the old paradigm and the new paradigm, however, is very turbulent. And that is what we are seeing right now. We're in very turbulent times, and there is no clear-cut answer. There's no clear-cut, good versus bad in reading or in making analysis on how things are going right now. We're missing somebody.
Lois. Who showed up, or?
Yeah. Oh, gosh. Anyway, good man.
He had an accent that spills.
Oh, all of this. Okay, so, Paul's gonna walk us through all of that tonight. He's got a little bit of a longer presentation. We're not gonna have a new paradigm or a society specific presentation, but we're gonna try and wrap our heads around this international situation, which is heating up, or just in great flux, I would say for sure. I do want to take this moment just to highlight something, and I think it's worth pointing out. What some of the mainstream outlets are trying to say right now is that we should all, delete our Facebook accounts, which is phenomenal. It's a phenomenal thing for them to say. Facebook has been instrumental in many things that are not good. They've been instrumental in fomenting and subverted and co-opted movements. They can be blamed for a heck of a lot, and this includes social media. This includes all of the Senate hearings that have been going on with all of the usual suspects: Google, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter. All of these outlets have fully disclosed now that they have been working with the CIA and the NSA for a very, very long time. Anyone who's been in the computer business, understands how this happens. But what's interesting now is that they want us to unplug. And what I have contended all, since I first opened a Facebook account, was that for all the bad things that Facebook can do, it actually is doing a hell of a lot. But I bring this up, a hell of a lot of good. I bring this up because when I first heard about the LaRouche movement, I started reading the Executive Intelligence Group. And when the EIR has been out for, I think it's 44 years now? 44 years. Once a week, every week, for 44 years. And this is intelligence from around the world. So when I first looked at it, I realized that before the internet, there was the Executive Intelligence Review. Because what we're told, and what I'm finding now more and more often from people that I'm meeting, is that I would say 90% of the people that I'm talking to, and that's a high number, do not believe what the mainstream media is telling them. Now, at the time, before the internet, when the Executive Intelligence Review was bringing what would have been considered, conspiracy theory or, inside, the news doesn't tell me this. So why should I believe this? Because the news is not reporting this. This mindset is gone. I really believe that we're in an age where this mindset is gone. However, this is also contributing to the turbulent times that we're experiencing as well, because the challenge is not just to pinpoint, it's one thing to know that what you're being told is a lie. It's another thing to know why it's a lie and what is the actual truth. That is another thing altogether. And unfortunately, a lot of times it requires experience that the average person doesn't have. This movement has a lot of that experience on the ground, and you know, it's been felt throughout its history, and it's definitely not something to overlook. So now, of course, in the mainstream and elsewhere online, what this movement has been saying about the British role in manipulating and influencing wars and conflicts and the gambling economy and all of that is really coming to the fore. And also in that regard, online, on Facebook, on YouTube, on the rest of it, that message is really getting out. And at this point, social media is not something that they can really shut down. They literally can't physically shut down at this point. And so, as a truth warriors that we are, and others all around the world, we are going to continue fighting. Now, I just want to go through a couple things before I bring Paul up here. We have, on that note, we are publishing a booklet. And we are raising money to do this. We are opening up a Patreon online fundraising site. It's not open yet, but we're raising money on our website. We're going to be asking people to help out either with funds or with time or energy, whatever you can. Essentially, we are making one of these for Canada. And it's going to be available in print. It's going to be available online. And what we are asking for our funds for is our website capability to step that up, to be able to have the sophistication that it deserves and capabilities. We are also going to be printing, so that is part of the cost as well. And then, of course, we're putting on our conference in July, where we'll be presenting these ideas. And what we're doing is we are giving the Canadian policy or decision makers the tools with which to navigate through these turbulent times. Because it's increasingly in Canada, it looks like the federal government, there is a giant vacuum of ineptitude, negligence, incompetence, and utterly obsessive focus on meaningless drivel. This includes pumping billions of money into a green economy, which is, we are already feeling the pinch here, very greatly. This means that CRA is no longer allowed to say Mr. and Mrs. This is what our energy is being put into. Conversely, while these billions of dollars are being sucked out of the system, and they really have no idea how to fix it. They really don't. And this is what I found over and over again. A lot of people like to pontificate that, they're in on it, they're all in on it, they're just greedy, and yes, that is a big problem, clearly. Excuse me. But, and this is worthy of a presentation at some point in the future, but I'll just say this. Incompetence and greed go hand in hand. And we've had a lot of these internal discussions amongst ourselves about this in our core group about this very problem. And what we're facing is the end of an empire. And at the end of an empire, it starts to unravel. And you have the incompetence taking over as the fundamental value. And we're seeing this in commerce, we're seeing this in government bureaucracies, and so the challenge again is to point the direction, to tell these people what principles need to be followed in order to get things back on track. And that's not telling them specifically what to do, but it is giving them the principles with which to go forward. And so that's what we're going to be doing with the four laws. So again, that's Glass-Steagall, national banking, so Bank of Canada being used for what it's supposed to be used for. That includes the infrastructure plans. So we're putting together quite a package that we're going to be presenting. And we've got some expert help on that as well. And then, of course, the final one is the science driver economy. And so the concept of energy density, we're going to be giving that a lot of weight to communicate to the policymakers. So that is what we're doing. And I'm going to keep reminding people, and we're going to, as the discussion develops and as we get closer to our deadline, I am going to be continuing to bring it up. So on that note, we have our fundraiser tickets. And this is all, of course, going to help. You can buy one for 10 or three for 20. If you would like one, you can come get them. Or if you want to take a bunch to sell yourself, then let me know and I'll write down the numbers that you're taking, bundles of 10 or whatever.
Not to mention, Phil sold his 10 already.
Phil sold his 10 already before anyone else, so we've got some work to do, the rest of us. So this is, again, it's for an iRobot Roomba. It's a $700 automatic robot vacuum that vacuums you for, provided you don't have cats, children, or dogs.
Oh, cats.
Or carpet.
It chases them all over the place.
That's right, it does too, actually.
They play with it.
Funny videos. We're not going to be drawing this, though, until all 150 tickets are sold. So call your friends, call your family. They don't have to know who LaRouche is. You don't have to, organize them necessarily to help us raise the money. The money will then go to organize society after we get this publication out.
I figure everyone's got 10 friends at least. If they don't, they should get at least 10.
Find 10 friends. So we've got 75, 80 to go here. And then once 80 tickets are sold, then we will draw. And there's two prizes. The one is for $700, and then the other one is the thermos.
Consolation prize.
Yep. So let me know if you want those, and I will bring Paul up.
Wow.